Good morning, Saints. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Welcome to the house, and welcome to this beautiful day that we have out here in God's paradise. So happy to be here. Lord, we're just so thankful for this day, and we thank you for this opportunity to be at Grace Baptist Church of Germantown. No matter how you're joining us this morning, we just want you to know that we're praising God. We're lifting his name on high. If you just join me in this brief word of prayer, and before that, I just want to read a couple of stanzas of Psalm 121. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, we thank you again for this day, and we humble ourselves before you as we invite your spirit, Lord, to be here with us, Lord. We, Lord, want to feel you this morning, Lord. We want you to lift up that preacher, Lord, Reverend Monts. And Lord, empower her with a word from you, Lord, as we invite the Holy Spirit just to come right here, Lord. Come today. Heavenly Father, we just know that we have so much to be thankful for. First of all, you woke us up this morning. But Lord, you've given us an opportunity to hear your words coming from the mouth of a believer, Lord. Coming, Lord, to the ears and going to the ears of those who want to hear your word. Thank you, Father, for these and all your blessings. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. And at this time, we're just going to thank the Lord in a very special way. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you, Lord. Let's do it again. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you, Lord. Amen, amen, and amen.
Well, praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
Bless his holy name this morning, because he is worthy of all praise, all honor, and all glory. So let's pray to the Lord. I want to pray to lift up Psalms 133.
Yes.
How good and pleasant it is when God's people live together in unity. It is like precious oil poured out on the head, running down on the beard. Running down on Aaron's beard, down on the collar of his robe. It is as if the dew of Hermon were falling on Mount Zion, for there the Lord bestows his blessings, even forevermore. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, our Savior and our friend, who redeemed us from the pit, from hell, and gave us life eternal. Lord, I pray for the unity of your godly children, for the church, the universal church, Lord, and the church here at Grace Baptist Church. Lord, let us come together as brethren in one body, for we have many parts, but there is only one body and one Holy Spirit that governs us all. Let us remember that, Lord. As we come together and worship, the church is not the body of Christ. We are the body of Christ. And I pray for the unity of the body of Christ here at Grace and in all throughout the universal church, Lord. So much has happened. We've splintered and broken. We've followed after the doctrines of men instead of the doctrine of Jesus Christ, seeking political things when they have nothing to do with the unity of Christ. And if the church would come together, we could help this world, this nation, be a better place for all of us. And so, Father, I just lift up this prayer that you would hear the voice of your daughter praying for the unity of the church. I know that you hear us, Lord, because the Bible says that if we ask anything in your name, you would give it to us. And so, Father, I just pray that you would help this body of Christ to continue to grow, continue to seek your face, your wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, and not that of the world and of men, because only truth comes from Jesus, and that is the only truth that we need. And so, Father, unify the church, the universal church, the church here at Grace Baptist Church of Germantown. Bless us and keep us, Lord, and help us to seek you and to do your will. Because if we do your will, Lord, we know that we will have done the right thing and we have moved and advanced the kingdom of Jesus Christ. So bless us, Father, this day. Keep us. Bless those who are coming to bring the message. Bless the people who are here. Help our AV team, Lord, who is doing a great job, to continue to be blessed, Lord. Give to their families and help them to seek your face. Help us all, Lord, to do what you want us to do so that we can bring glory and honor and praise to your name. To God be the glory forever. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Good morning again, saints. Good morning, good morning. It is now that special time. It's giving time. Amen. It is giving time. So, Lord, as we know, as we lift your name on high today, we just ask you to continue to support our church in your very special way. We know that there's so many ways to give. That's time, talent, and money. But this time right now, we're asking you just to give a little bit of what the Lord has blessed you with. And so if you'll join me in prayer before we go into this special moment here in giving. We thank you, Jesus, again for this day. We thank you for the opportunity to bless us with just a portion of what you've blessed us with, Lord, to be able to give and to share and to show our love for you, Lord. Lord, we know that in order to do ministry, Lord, to be able to live out the meaning of Matthew 28, Lord, when we talk about going out and just bringing more disciples to God, Father, we thank you for the blessings just that you continue to give us so that we can give back to you. You came, Lord, not to be served, but to serve. And right now, Lord, we're assuring you that your example is perfect in every way, because now, Lord, we are serving. And we're serving those not only in our church, but especially those in our community, because we're here to serve. We thank you for this opportunity to give. In Jesus' name we pray, amen, amen, and amen. Good morning, Grace. What a blessed day. I was sitting over there in my lawn chair and breeze came through, and then somebody told me to behave myself when I got up here. So she's shaking her head now, so I'll go straight to the scripture. We're going to wait and let folks get in just a minute or two, I'm sorry. And then we're going to ask for everyone's attention for the scripture. Is that Mrs. Pinkett? No. Oh, that's May Williams. While we're waiting on everyone to get settled, would you turn with me, if you will, to John 8, verse 12. All right. That would be in the New Testament, John 8, verse 12. If all hearts and spirits are quiet, we will read what said the Lord. John 8, verse 12. When Jesus spoke again to the people, he said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." May the Lord bless his holy word. Amen.
Thou forever will be.
winter and springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above. Join with all nations in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hands have provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto thee. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hands have provided. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto thee.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Bless you.
Great is thy faithfulness. Yes. I love that hymn. Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
Yeah, Reverend.
And I thank God for this morning.
Yeah, Reverend. Say it.
Thank God for the opportunity to preach a word to his people and to the surrounding community. To preach a word to my church family, Grace Baptist
God.
Church.
God.
Thanking God for, and giving him honor for everything.
Yes.
And thanking our wonderful and dynamic pastor,
Lord, yes. Be with you, Reverend.
The Reverend Dr. J.H. Henry Buck,
yes. Call his name, Reverend.
For Call giving his me name. The opportunity to preach from this sacred desk. And we are all on holy ground.
Yes. Yes.
It has been blessed.
Yes, Reverend.
As Pastor Harris told us this morning, it is blessed.
Yes.
You are blessed. And I thank God for you this morning.
My, my.
And for those that are online, on
Amen.
Facebook,
Amen.
On YouTube.
Amen.
Good morning. I praise God for you and I thank God for you. Let us look to the Lord first. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for this moment, this opportunity to preach your word to your people. I pray that everybody would hear you and would feel you on this moment, dear Lord, that you will decrease me and that your Holy Spirit will surround and fill each and every one of us. We thank you, Lord, for all that you continue to do for us. And we thank you for withholding the things that you know that we do not need because we need you more. I love you, Lord, and I thank you. And it's in Jesus' name that I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I'll read the scripture again for your hearing and for those that are also coming into the parking lot. And excuse my raspy voice. For the past 2 weeks, for whatever reason, it got a little raspy, but, you know, devil won't have his way.
That's right.
We'll
That's
still
right.
try to get through this without losing it. All right.
That's all right, Reverend.
So I'm coming from the Gospel of John, chapter 8, verse 12. And it says in the NIV version, "Then Jesus spoke to them again, saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." And the title of my sermon today is called Shine the Light on Them.
All right, Reverend. Yes. Shine the light.
So I like going to birthday parties. And if I'm invited to a birthday party, I will be there unless there's some major conflict in my schedule. But I like birthday parties, especially milestone parties, because birthday parties are simply a blessing. It's a blessing that God has allowed you to see another year, another month, another day, another hour, and another moment in time. I like to celebrate birthdays because we just never know when God will call us home, although it's always in his good and perfect time. So the last milestone birthday party I attended was my cousin's 60th birthday party. So it was an all-white party. Everybody was dressed in white, looking lovely, and she wore a little blue outfit with white shoes. And it was nice seeing family. But the part that I really liked was when the DJ played this song called Shine the Light on Them.
All right.
So this song prompts the birthday party attendees to take out their cell phones and put it on flashlight mode and shine the light on the birthday girl or the birthday person. It's their time to shine. But it is the light from others that make that person feel special. But if your phone is dead and doesn't have enough battery life, it prevents you from celebrating the birthday person. So when we are unable to shine our light on others, people start to feel unloved and neglected. But it prompts me to ask this question. Did you charge your battery today so that you can shine your light on others? In this book of John, he's really about talking about how Jesus is the light. John was a disciple and friend who sat on the front row of Jesus' life. He is the head reporter and eyewitness to the good news in Jesus' ministry. He experienced some of Jesus' intimate moments, such as the Mount of Transfiguration in the Garden of the Gethsemane, and witnessed Jesus' death on the cross. John's portrait of Jesus illuminates the fact that he is the Son of God. His goal was to make the world aware of Jesus' deity by providing powerful testimony of his life, death, and resurrection. But here in this passage, Jesus is giving his own testimony about who he is to the Pharisees as they try to invalidate who he is. But this is not the first time or the last time that Jesus will drop truth on the Pharisees. But I love this passage of scripture because it brings me back to some Old Testament things. It's a reminder of who is the I Am.
All right.
And the I Am that I Am is the only life and life giver. And you may be asking, well, how do you know that he is the life and light giver?
All right.
Well, I'm glad that you asked. And I'll give you several answers.
Yeah.
You know, this morning, I woke up, and I inhaled, and I exhaled.
That's right.
We are only here by God's good grace.
Yeah, thank you, Lord.
And after everything that I ever did, whether it was good or bad, I know without a shadow of doubt that he loves me and called me out of the darkness into his marvelous light. The way to experience him and to know him is to walk with him. He says it in the scripture. You know, when you walk with people, you commune and you conversate with them. And it's the same way with Jesus. And can anyone out here testify that you just feel better starting your day with the Lord?
Yes.
Even if the day does not go right, you know that you will be all right because you have the light. You know, it is our choice to be lit or to be dim.
All right,
and I'm going to put a pin right there because I'm going to come back to that point
on,
in a moment. But I do have three things to say about the light, and then I'll be out of your way. You know, the light that shines is safe and effective. There is 100% certainty that the light is safe and effective. We are all living examples of the light's safety and effectiveness. God kept the Israelites safe in the wilderness with a pillar of light. He kept you safe to this day with his light. And we know there is nothing to fear when we have the light with us. We know that the light is good and that darkness cannot overcome it. We know that the light keeps us safe in God's arms. And that there may be tests and trials that may come your way, but the light will make you better, stronger, and wiser. I don't know about you all, but there have been times in my life when the light was dim. My inner light was dim because I didn't know the Lord. I was letting the world get the best of me. Even while saved by the grace of God, sometimes, yes, I too had some issues. See, walking in sin is not safe. Depression is not safe. Doing things my own way was not safe. I was not safe. I lived in so much darkness that I couldn't see where I was going or what was coming my way. But, you know, some of the people that I called friends at the time, they even stopped speaking to me or walked away when I needed them to show me Christ's light and his love. But let me tell you something, God never left.
Talk, Reverend.
In his word, Jesus says, I will never leave you nor forsake you.
Yes, Lord.
So when you decide to change your circumstance, when I decided to change my circumstances, when I made up my mind to follow the light, be the light, and then I learned how to shine that light on others, everything was all right. Jesus is the light who advocates for us and settles our cares and concerns. You know, for more than 20 years, I've been teaching parents and young adults about being an advocate for their health, their children's health, and even their own health. And I also learned how to be my own advocate by doing my research and asking questions and demanding answers and being prayerful and discerning about the people who have my best interests. We all have the evangelistic responsibility to be Christ's advocates and to shine his light on those that do not know him. Matthew 5:16 says, let your light shine before men so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. It's our testimonies and those things that we do without payback that allows the world to see the light that shines in you. But not only is the light safe and effective, it will also keep you from dangers seen and unseen.
Yes.
The light is God's protection. And God has continued to keep us, and he has kept me and still continues to keep us from dangers seen and unseen. I have a story. When I was 7 years old, I was riding my bike on a late afternoon. It was a school day. And my mom gave me permission to ride my bike. It was a warm spring evening, and my mother told me before I went outside to ride my bike that I needed to be in the house before the street lights came on.
Okay.
Some must remember we had to be in, I'm not that young to know that I had to be in the house by the time them street lights were on.
Yeah.
But I was a responsible and obedient kid for the most part, so my mother trusted me to do what she said, for the most part. And so if the street lights were on, that meant it was too dark for me to be outside riding my bike. Well, I was on my bike having fun and passed the time to come in the house. While riding my bike, something made me hit my brakes really hard, and then I flipped over my handlebars. So now I'm on the ground, and blood was everywhere. And so my neighbor saw me, saw what happened, picked me up, and picked my bike up, and took me home. And this was also in the 80s where, you know, we had a sense of community, and everybody looked after one another.
Yeah.
So I was appreciative of that. But my mother was first shocked that I was hurt and that I was still outside after the street lights came on. Well, she didn't have to punish me because that night I had to go to the emergency room in fear that I would need stitches on my chin. Well, thank God that part was spared, but I did have a sprained wrist. It could have been worse. I could have been riding my bike in the street and been hit by a car. I could have had some broken bones. While falling on my face, I could have had a concussion or a traumatic brain injury. But the fact that I was outside while it was dark caused me to stumble and fall. If I would have paid attention to what was above and in front of me, if I would have been, if I would have not disobeyed my mother, I would have been safe in the home and uninjured. You know, I still had this little tiny scar on my chin as a reminder that I was kept from danger seen and unseen. But most recently, I was kept from danger seen and unseen while I was carrying little Joshua. So that labor and delivery process was long and difficult, and Joshua came earlier than expected. But you know, in a time where black mothers are dying at alarming rates during childbirth, I was blessed to have people who even didn't look like me listen and pay attention to everything that was happening. They saw things happening that I could not see and acted swiftly. And what I could see and feel, they listened to my concerns. But isn't that how God is? And we just thank our God that he always listens to us and that he cares and that he has concern for his children. Oh, to be kept. Oh, to be kept. And finally, the light is eternal life. When we are secure in our faith that Jesus' light is eternal life, we can reach a multitude and make disciples for the kingdom. He was sent to us to be a standard and example of what it is to love God and love people. He was sent here to be the blood sacrifice for my sins and your sins. He was sent here to save all of humanity. But as I come back to my point about being lit or dim, it's about time some of us get lit. Now, I'm not talking about the Urban Dictionary's meaning of what the world does in the dark at the bars and the nightclubs. But I'm talking about being excited and ecstatic and having joy and being unapologetic about losing ourselves and be ignited by the light of the world. We should be so lit that people not only see the light, but they can feel the light. Jesus is the eternal light that never burns out. And you know, changes in life may be difficult and attempt to blow out our inner light, but we can always be replenished by the light of the world. You know, it only takes one candle to light thousands of other candles. Don't keep that light to yourselves. Share your inner light with others so that they may see and know who gives eternal light. You know, my first introduction over 17 years ago to Jesus, I won't even say to the church, but just to Jesus, because they didn't talk about church first. They talked about Jesus. My friends, who were probably more holier than me at that time, you know, would tell me about how they would go to church and how the preaching that they heard was meaningful and how it changed their lives. And they didn't really tell me, like, you know, go read your Bible or go to church. They just shared the light that was inside of them with me. And seeing how the light changed them and hearing it enough, I became excited and ecstatic about making my own personal decision to accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. I followed my faithful friends right to the light. Best decision I've ever made. And I was dim and needed to be lit. And it sometimes it's those haters, those troublemakers, and Satan's instigators that will lead you to darkness. But those of us who are lit and shining, we have been called to shine the light and to tell somebody about Jesus. Well, I also want to switch gears, and as I close the end of my sermon, to also have an evangelistic responsibility. And telling some folk, it may not be anybody in here, but you can also share the gospel with them and telling them to get vaccinated.
My God, my God.
We're just like living, we're really living in a time where it's not the vaccinated that's being sick, it's the unvaccinated. We were looking up statistics this morning, and only in Philadelphia, only 24% of African Americans have one dose of the vaccine as of now. And we have some work to do. You know, the vaccine is safe and effective against hospitalizations and the death from COVID-19. And please don't wait until you are infected or affected by this virus, because it may be too late. You know, I've seen that, like, I work with children, and even some of the children have some long-lasting effects of what happens to them when they are infected with the virus. And even a lot of emotional and psychological long-term tolls on their health as well. Know that this vaccine is approved for FDA use, approved by the FDA for emergency use authorization. It is approved by the FDA, regardless of what somebody tell you. But just make sure that you tell somebody it's important.
Thank you, Reverend.
And that you extend that, not only for them to take care of themselves, but to also take care of their community. Amen.
Amen. That's the light there, Reverend.
Amen. Amen.
Come on, let us give God praise for this preacher this morning, shining the light. Not only just the light of the word, but even the light of our social situation that we're dealing with at this time. Let me extend this invitation of Jesus Christ to you. If you do not know who the light is, we extend this invitation to let the light shine on you. If there be anyone who's watching us, who's listening to us, who may be in this community, and you are feeling the pains and the problems of darkness, as Pastor Monts has just stated so efficaciously and effectively, that there is a light, and that light is Jesus Christ, and that light can be in you today. Greater is he that is within us than he whom is in the world. And so we invite you to accept Christ as your Savior. If you're watching us, we invite you to accept Christ as your Savior on today. You may be in this community today, and you may have just raised your window just to hear what those folks are doing right up there on the corner of Johnson Street and Germantown Avenue, right here at G. Daniel Jones Way. We want to say to you, as you have your windows open, let the Lord come in. Let him come into your life. This is the day the Lord has made. This is your day of salvation. You can rejoice and be glad in it. You may say, well, I hear that guy over there on the microphone, and we've heard the sermon and all of that, and I don't have a church to go to get baptized. Come on up the street. We're waiting for you. If there be anyone, and if you need to repair your relationship with Jesus Christ and need to be reconciled to the body of Christ, we certainly invite you to come. Will there be one? Will there be one? Back in the days of old, Pastor Monts, the church of old would, when they would have the old revival tent meetings like now, like we're having this worship service, but I want you to know this has always been the tradition of the church. COVID didn't start this. The church has been doing this for many generations. Now, we may have gotten away from it, but I thank God that God has caused a situation to remind us that when you didn't have the beautiful organs and the nice bass guitars and the nice drums and all of that, the only thing you had was human capital. That was the clapping of your hand and the stomping of your feet. And so we praise God for this moment. But Pastor Monts, the church of old, would raise a hymn. And they didn't have the organs and all of that, but they would raise a hymn when they had them old tent services. And I think we need to raise a hymn because we got one of these tent services going on. So if you would just join us in just this fellowship song, and I think that it is one that is very appropriate. Jesus, keep me near the cross. And for those who are watching, for those seeing where you are, Pastor Monts has just said the light is within you. Let the light shine on. You may be in the supermarket right now. Stop where you are in the aisle and just sing, Jesus, keep me near the cross. I guarantee you to send a whole nother environment across the market. So let us raise this hymn this morning. If you are in your cars, we praise God for you. If you could see the number of people who are here today, praise God. Come on. Jesus, keep me near thy cross. There's a precious fountain free to all. A healing stream flows from Calvary's mountain. Come on, let the light shine. In thy cross, in thy cross, be my glory ever till my raptured soul shall find rest beyond the river. Come on, let's do that one more time. If the light is shining in you, in thy cross, in thy cross, be my glory ever till my raptured soul shall find rest beyond the river. Amen. Now, come on, take a moment and just give God a hand clap of praise wherever you are. For those of you who are in your cars, for those of you who are out here on the lawn, amen. For those of you who are listening in through our prayer line, for those of you who are watching virtually, praise God for you. Let me take this privilege and this opportunity to ask your prayers for the Massey family. Let us continue to keep Deacon Prince Massey and Mrs. Lorraine Massey lifted in prayer as they laid to rest her mother and his mother-in-law on yesterday. Amen. How you doing, ma'am? I see you driving by. Praise God. Pull the car over and come on over here and have some worship with us. Amen. This is Holy Ghost headquarters. Amen. Look, she pulling over. See that? Amen. Amen. If you never invite them, they'll never come. Amen. We actually, once again, just want to keep the Massey family lifted in prayer. We equally received word on this morning about the transitioning of the brother of one of our serving trustees, Brother Irvin Chester. So please keep the Chester family lifted in prayer. His brother transitioned late yesterday evening. And so once we get the information, we will make sure that we inform you of everything that is going on with him. Once again, let us continue to keep all of our people. Please keep Brother Chris Roberts, Mrs. Ladea Roberts, lifted in prayer as well. It is good to see so many of you here today. If we could just swing the camera around, maybe we'll just get one of those. Come on, Scott. Come on. Swing the camera around so folk can see them on the parking lot. They out here in the chairs, one parking over there. Amen. See that? Look, everybody on the parking lot. There you go. Wave your hand. Wave your hand. Amen. They're over there. Look. Amen. And some people have some wonderful testimonies that are out here today. Amen. Just to show you, that's our AV team over there. We got some people in the parking lot. Sister Sandy Johnson over there waving like a princess. Look at her, waving her hand. Amen. Amen. Our preachers are here. Amen. Amen. And just look at the beautiful faces that are out here. Amen. We praise God for all of you. Did the preacher not preach this morning? Amen. Come on. Did our hearts not burn? Amen. We thank God for all of these preachers that are here at Grace Baptist Church of Germantown. I'm going to go on the record for saying here in the year of 2021, there are no better preachers than the preachers of Grace. Amen. There are no better preachers. And I don't care who watching this. There are no better preachers than the preachers at Grace. Amen. You are missing a for sure treat when these preachers are declaring God's word. Amen. That's all I have. We thank. Let me say this before I go. We pray traveling mercies for our Boy Scouts. Our Boy Scouts are actually going to camp today, and so we pray traveling mercies. I saw Dr. Sam Coleman over there. Dr. Coleman, are you here? Dr. Coleman, can you come and just give us an update? We know that our young men are headed to camp, so we're going to ask Reverend Dr. Sam Coleman to come and lift a word of prayer for our Boy Scouts. Amen. Come on, give God praise for him, for his leadership, Reverend Brian Wallace, and all of them who lead our young men. Come on, Dr. Coleman, pray for our young men who are headed to camp. Give God praise, Reverend Dr. Sam Coleman.
Thank you very much, Pastor. I just want to say very well done, Reverend Monts. That was a wonderful sermon, especially reminding our community to get vaccinated. Okay? All the data is out there, hello, that says get vaccinated. Okay, and I have some people in my life that said that they just waiting and waiting. And I've been telling them I love you too much to have you sitting around waiting to get vaccinated. And I've told people I'm not going to hang around you until you get vaccinated. Grace, I love you. And if you are a member of Grace and you are not vaccinated, we can't be cool until you get those that one shot or those two shots. So I love you, but get vaccinated. Our scouts are on their way up to Resaca Falls. These are our Boy Scouts. These are the older boys, and so we just want to pray for them right now because they're going to be out there for a week, and so in the woods, and some know, you know, where they're going. There are bears up there, and there are all kind of things out there in the woods, you know. And I remember as a youth having to say, "Stay in your campsite. There was a bear sighting," but that's okay, you know. So let us pray for our boys. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you, O Lord, for the lives of our Boy Scouts and Troop 358 that are on their way to summer camp this very morning. We pray, O Lord, that they have a safe and wonderful week in your name. We ask for you to protect them and guide them through this week. Keep them safe, O Lord, and bring them back to us, O Lord, that they have had a great week in fellowship in your name. They've learned some great tools to become positive young men in our society, O Father God. Be with those leaders and those adults that are with them this week, O Father God, that you will also protect them and guide them in all that they might endure. Let them have a blessed week in your name and bring them back to us safe. Let us also remember to keep us all in your everlasting sights, O Father God. As we continue to walk this city, we've seen a rise in gun violence. We've seen a rise in COVID cases, O Father God. But we right now, Lord, that we have fear, faith over fear. And fear is nothing more than false evidence appearing real. So when that fear comes before us, O Father God, remember that we have faith in you. And it is that faith that has sustained us, molded us, and kept us, O Father God, as one body in Christ. As long as we have faith, we can do anything in you. We thank you, O Father God, for these things and all things in the precious name of Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. Amen. God bless you.
Amen, amen. Continuously pray for our church, our members, and their families, our ministries, as we are still doing ministry.
Amen.
Even as the Boy Scouts go out, they're still doing ministry.
Yes, ma'am.
Showing us that we can live, you know, outside and be a light.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Let us look to the Lord for our benediction. Our Father and our God, thank you, Lord, for all that you are doing.
Yes.
Thank you, God, and I pray that as we go out into this world, that your light will shine on each and every one of us, that we will be examples, Christ examples to people, that we will continue to love on one another as you have taught us to love. We thank you, God. I just ask for safe traveling mercies for this day and even throughout this week as we go to our various destinations. I just ask that you cover, bless, and protect each household. Keep us from danger seen and unseen. And it's in Jesus' name that I pray, and let the church say amen.
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 And amen.
Amen.